this morning. All kids develop, of course, at different speeds, but when it comes to language, most experts agree on some milestones for what's normal. So are you worried that your child or your grandchild's speech or language might be delayed?
Well, this month is Better Hearing and Speech Month, so we've asked a speech-language pathologist to join us. It's Jenny Herklotz, and she's here to talk about when a child needs an evaluation and what you can do at home to help your child. Good to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
Nice to see you.
I'm really interested in this particularly because my niece right now is not doing a lot of talking. She's got an older brother, and I think a lot of people experience this sort of nerve within a family when one child isn't talking as much or using their words to express what they want. And this is kind of the month that you want people to think about this topic, right?
Yes, absolutely. Our national organization, which is ASHA, or American Speech and Hearing Association, has designated the month of May every year towards awareness for speech and language and hearing disorders. And this year, every year they have a different theme, and this year the topic is early intervention counts. So it's really about bringing awareness to how important early intervention is with children.
See, and I think this is such a tricky area for parents and probably for experts like you too, because a lot of parents will learn from their pediatrician, for example, or from their parents, grandparents. Every kid develops at a different age. Don't freak out. Some of these things will work themselves out. But yet, then you want to be, you don't want to overreact, but you don't want to underreact either. And as it relates to early intervention, what kinds of things could you be looking for specifically and at what age that might be cause for concern?
Well, so there's many different things that we look for in red flags, and really I tell parents first off and foremost, I encourage all parents that if they're ever concerned, pick up the phone and call a certified speech language pathologist who can talk you through whether it's time to look into it or if waiting is a good idea. But we really encourage parents to not wait and see, so to speak. We get a lot of the, oh, well, my uncle didn't talk until he was three, and so your kid will be fine. And there are a lot of actual neurological disorders that with early intervention can be treated, and our ASHA, our organization, just came out with what I think is an astounding figure, where for every $1 spent in early intervention, a parent saves $7 in later life. So it just goes to show us that early intervention really is key for saving time and money and is really more effective than waiting till later on and doing therapy at a later age.
Are there some milestones that parents should just be aware of that, you know, they should be talking this amount or they shouldn't have this sort of social skill, you know, that's lacking at this point?
Yeah, well, most children are showing signs, some sort of signs, by 18 to 24 months old, believe it or not. Okay. So we can start therapy that young. Obviously, children who have disorders that we know about at birth, such as Down syndrome or cerebral palsy, will start therapy earlier very often. But I think you want to look for a child for social skills, like you mentioned. If the child is not showing eye contact, not pointing, you know, let's say you're reading a book and they're not pointing to pictures on the pages, or if you say, where's the cow, and they can't show you at a young age, that's something you definitely want to watch for. By 18 months old, children should typically have about 50 words, and by 2 years, they should have about 200 words and be combining words at that point.
So that's like, go look.
Mommy, no, no, uh-oh, you get a lot of that around the year-old.
Yeah.
And we
a lot of no. You hear a lot of no.
No, no.
Yeah, you get a lot of that.
And you do not want, you want to watch for, we don't count mommy and daddy in those sorts of words. And uh-oh and no-no do not count as combined words. So combined words, like you said, are more like daddy go or you know, mommy bye bye. Those are counts as combined words.
Because it's like it's a more of a a full thought? Is that what combined words represent?
Okay. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. At what point, because, you know, you said call a speech pathologist, is that at a school or somebody in a private practice, or how do you know where to start? You know, there's probably people sitting at home right now going, yeah, I'm kind of wondering, or a grandparent mm-hmm. was thinking, yeah, I should tell my daughter to maybe look into this. So how do you make that call? How do you find a good person?
It's a great question. There are, well, first of all, again, our national organization, if you go on their website, which is just asha.org, you can actually go under find a professional and put in your zip code and it'll pull up therapists around you. But there are county services, there are school services once a child hits school age, and then there are also private practitioners who work in private practice. And a lot of parents choose even to supplement what they get in the school with private practice, so the child is getting one-on-one therapy mm-hmm. services in a private sector.
And just so people aren't alarmed, there are certain things that are normal, right? Like reversing some words or the R sound or things that mm-hmm. sound like a speech impediment maybe for an adult. For kids, a lot of that can be quite typical, right, depending on their age.
Yeah, and that's where it comes in. And again, that's why a lot of times we say just call a therapist, because mm-hmm. we're happy to talk that through with you, because it really does depend on how old the child is. So a lot of times a five-year-old who says I love you mm-hmm. is not considered typical, but a two-year-old who does that is considered typically developing. So it really is going to depend on age when it comes to what's appropriate and what's not.
Okay. That's really good information. Yeah. I can't believe that for a dollar you spend in early intervention, mm-hmm. it adds up to $7 for each dollar later on. So that's a good reason to call someone early rather than later if you have concerns. You and other professionals, like you write some great articles in Metro Parent. I know your article about speech was in a few months ago, but it's a wonderful place to go, and you can find past articles as well if you go to metroparentmagazine.com. And the website that you just mentioned, we wanted to put up too, because this is a speech website. It's asha.org, and that stands for what?
American Speech and Hearing Association.
Wonderful. Great to meet you.
Thanks,
likewise.
Jenny.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it.